Good morning. In today's gospel, Jesus promises that our grief will be turned to joy. Today we celebrate the memorial of Saint Rita, who together with Saint Jude is the patron saint of impossible cases. As we continue to move slowly through this pandemic, we trust that Jesus will turn our grief into joy, and that Saint Rita will assist those researching for a vaccine to this virus. Today we also celebrate the Sacred Heart School 8th grade class's goodbye mass. Throughout this week, the students have spent time reflecting upon their 9 years at Sacred Heart School. During their class Google meets, placed upon the altar this morning are mementos of some of their favorite memories from the past 9 years.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
I'm hoping that you hear me all right. I feel like I'm speaking loudly, but I don't have as much amplification as usual. Father Keisha has taken care of that. But today we celebrate our school mass. This is the goodbye mass.
And even though this is a very difficult and strange time that we're in, the celebration still goes on. Our eighth graders are still graduating, and the celebration of this wonderful time of the end of the year and moving on to different and perhaps even better things, we ask God to bless them and strengthen them for the future. Coming together as God's family, we ask the Lord's forgiveness, for He is full of gentleness and compassion. Almighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Today we celebrate the memorial of Saint Rita of Cassia. Saint Rita had a very difficult life, which I will talk about in my homily, but then she went on to do wonderful things as an Augustinian sister and one who interceded for people, especially those in very difficult or even impossible cases. Let us pray. Bestow on us, we pray, O Lord, the wisdom and strength of the cross, with which you were pleased to endow Saint Rita, so that suffering in every tribulation with Christ, we may participate ever more deeply in his paschal mystery, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. One night, while Paul was in Corinth, the Lord said to him in a vision, "Do not be afraid. Go on speaking and do not be silent, for I am with you. No one will attack and harm you, for I have many people in this city." He settled there for a year and a half, and he taught the word of God among them. But when Gallio was proconsul of Achaia, the Jews rose up together against Paul and brought him to the tribunal, saying, "This man is inducing people to worship God contrary to the law." When Paul was about to reply, Gallio spoke to the Jews, "If it were a matter of some crime and malicious fraud, I should with reason hear the complaint of you Jews. But since it is a question of arguments over doctrine and titles, in your own law, see to it yourself. I did not wish to be a judge of such matters." And he drove them away from the tribunal. They all seized Sosthenes, the synagogue official, and beat him in full view of the tribunal. But none of this was of concern of Gallio. Paul remained for quite some time. After saying farewell to the brothers, he sailed for Syria, together with Priscilla and Aquila. Since he had shaved his head because he had taken a vow, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The response is, God is King of all the earth.
God is King of all the earth.
All you peoples, clap your hands, shout to God with cries of gladness. For the Lord, the Most High, the Awesome, is the great King of all the earth.
God is the King of all the earth.
He brings people under us, nations under our feet. He chooses for our own inheritance the Lord of Jacob, whom he loves.
God is the King of all the earth.
God mourns his throne amid shouts of joy, the Lord amid trumpets blast. Sing praise to God, sing praise. Sing praise to our King, sing praise.
God is the King of all the earth.
Christ had to suffer and to rise from the dead, and so enter into his Lord.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "Amen, amen, I say to you, you will weep and mourn, while the world rejoices. You will grieve, but your grief will become joy. When a woman is in labor, she is in anguish because her hour has arrived. But when she has given birth to a child, she no longer remembers the pain because of her joy that a child has been born into the world. So you also are now in anguish. But I will see you, and your hearts will rejoice, and no one will take your joy away from you. On that day, you will not question me about anything. Amen, amen, I say to you, whatever you ask the Father in my name, he will give you. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
On that day, you will not question me about anything. Having been an educator myself before I became a priest, I know that education really is all about questions. We learn about ourselves, we learn about our environment, and other nations, other cultures, all by asking the right questions. And by asking those questions, we can make informed decisions for ourselves, and we can make informed decisions for our children. Our children's lives are deeply formed by the decisions that parents make and that society makes too. And so parents made the crucial decision to send their children to Catholic education. And that is a beautiful thing, because that can bear much fruit in the lives of children. And we believe that that decision that they made will positively affect the lives of their children for throughout their lives, for as long as they live. So, there's a lot of questions that people ask. People are asking questions of us as teachers, as a principal, as the pastor, so they can be fully informed, so they can make the right decisions for their children and help their lives to be fully in Christ and fully ready to face the world. That's why it's so amazing for Jesus to say that a day is going to come, he says, on that day, you will not ask me about anything. You'll have no questions at all. What is that day? Well, there's a lot of interpretations of what that day could be, a lot of different times in our lives. But ultimately, that day is when we face God, when we're at the judgment seat of God, and God is asking us how we use the gifts that he gave us, how we spent our lives. Do we spend our lives for love? Or do we spend our lives for hurt or for tearing down other people? And that's going to be the question in the evening of life. And the way that we respond to that question, the way our lives show the answer to that question, is certainly very important. And so there's a lot of need for genuine understanding about the way that we ask the questions, the way that we live our lives based on the decisions we make as a result of those questions we ask. Think, though, of those who don't need to ask questions. I think, first of all, of the peaceful look between a husband and wife when some difficulty comes their way. And they simply look at each other, and they know instantly that things are going to be okay. It's going to be difficult, it's going to be painful, but we're going to face this together, we're going to get through this. It takes years for most couples to develop that. But I've seen it over and over again from my parents and other couples that I have known in my life. And I think of elderly people, many people that I've visited in their homes at nursing facilities or hospitals, and they have that feeling of, yes, God is bringing me through this. They may be in suffering. They might be in pain. They might have a lot of difficulty as a result of their situation. But in spite of that, they really are not asking any questions. They're simply understanding that God's going to bring them through this time, and they're ready to go home. The only question they might ask me is, why doesn't Jesus take me now? Why do I have to wait? And of course, they most of the time answer the question themselves. Oh yeah, I've got a child who needs to see me again. I have a grandchild. I have a sister or brother. I have a niece or nephew, and they need to see me. They need to understand that they're going to be all right even after I'm gone. And that knowing, that understanding, is a tremendous gift. Saint Rita had a lot of reasons to question God. She had a very difficult life. First of all, she never wanted to be married. She never wanted to have a husband. But her parents insisted, as was common at that time, that she be married. And so they arranged a marriage for her. Unfortunately, the man to whom she was to be married to was known as a brutal man. He was angry, he was cruel, he was difficult to live with. And she had a very hard marriage. And she also had two hot-headed sons. Well, her husband got killed ultimately by others who didn't like the way he lived his life and didn't like his political decisions. So he was killed. His two sons said they were going to avenge his death. They were going to go out and hurt others for killing their father. Rita did not want this to happen at all. Rita wanted to protect other people. Even though they had done wrong, she didn't want the bloodshed to continue. And she prayed fervently that God would bring an end to the bloodshed. Well, what happened was even more painful than most of us would ever want to face. And that is, her two sons both died of natural causes. Then she, after going through a period of grief, as any mother would, she went into an Augustinian convent, and for 40 years she was there praying fervently for the world, and her life became more and more totally imbued with the power of Jesus Christ. She gave herself completely in prayer and love to the Lord. And people would come and ask her for advice, and she would always give the best advice. She would always have the most confidence in God. She, along with St. Jude, as was said in the introduction, are the patron saints of impossible cases, because they faced impossible things in their lives, and they went through them with the ability to trust God, even though they didn't understand, even though things seemed to be very much out of control, at least for them. But they knew that God was going to bring them through these moments. St. Rita's life was filled with sad questions early on, but she was turned into a person of joy and of trust in God, because she knew the Lord was with her in the midst of this intense suffering. So intensity now was directed towards prayer. All of her life became a reflection of the light of Christ. Saint Rita could have become a bitter person, as many people have, but she became a great saint because she trusted God without having full understanding. That's one of the things that a saint does. they trust in the face of suffering. And we turn to her at this time when we have this very difficult situation that causes all kinds of changes in our lives. Nobody could have expected at the end of 2019 or even beginning 2020, except maybe a few people in China, that this could ever face us. But it has. This time of the pandemic has turned our lives upside down. And so we're facing that as a school, we're facing that as a parish too. And our eighth graders face a very different end to their school year. Teachers, though, and parents are working together to make this a special moment in their lives, in spite of the very different environment that we live in. The usual experiences that they had together, that you would normally have together, are being experienced online and through social media. This is still a time for celebration. I think that this class has been given a special mission because of what they've gone through, that the future will be in their hands, and I believe they will be very well equipped to face that future because they've gone through what none of any of us have gone through previous to this time. They've experienced this moment. And the role they will play for the future of our community and our world will be an important one. We ask Saint Rita to pray for us, that we will have a place of prayer and peace for each one of us, and that our futures be placed completely in the hands of God, that we'll trust Him to bring us through this time of the pandemic and into the future. Even after we come together as a parish community again, and unfortunately that's not happening right away, hopefully within a few weeks, but as we wait during this difficult time, we place our hands in and our lives in Jesus Christ's hands, because we trust Him, as Saint Rita did in spite of any suffering and pain in her life. We trust the Lord, and we know that ultimately He will bring good even out of difficult and painful situations. We ultimately know that Jesus Christ has a plan for our lives that's much better than we would plan for ourselves. We depend upon that, and we thank God that He has brought us new hope and a new time of rejoicing. So now let us bring our prayers to God, whose love for us has no end.
For the Holy Catholic Church, for Francis our Pope, Myron Cotta our Bishop, and for all our bishops and priests and deacons, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the graduating class of 2020, may they have the courage to make good decisions and continue to follow God's call. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for those who are leaving. We pray for those families who are leaving Sacred Heart School, especially the Crivelli family, the Crutcher family, the Ingram family, the Leonard family, the Lucas family, the Mession family, the Perez family, the Rowe family, and the Sanchez family. We thank you for your years of service and commitment to Sacred Heart School. May you find happiness in your endeavors and know that you are always a part of Sacred Heart family. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for the control of COVID-19 pandemic and for those working to find a vaccine, as well as for those on the front lines who are giving of themselves so that others may be helped. May they receive Christ's protection as they serve. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for those who are sick, especially those at the Church-Turlock Nursing and Rehabilitation Center, and for Luciana Terra. May the risen Christ visit them with healing power and new hope. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for the special intentions requested for this Mass. In memory of St. Rita, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Loving God, you are our help, our strength, and our salvation. Hear and answer the prayers we make in faith through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Pray, my friends, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
We bring the offerings of our devotion to be consecrated by you, O Lord, in commemoration of Saint Rita, and by the consolation you give us in this life, you show us that we should not lose hope of what is promised for eternity, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord. But in this time above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. By the oblation of his body, he brought the sacrifices of old to fulfillment in the reality of the cross. And by commending himself to you for our salvation, he showed himself to be the priest, the altar, and the lamb of sacrifice. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Oh,
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, so that sins may be forgiven. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Myron, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may always be free from sin and safe from all anxiety, as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity, where you live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Amen.
Grace is still prevailing.
Let us pray. Renewed, O Lord, at the wellsprings of salvation, we humbly entreat you, through the intercession of Saint Rita, holding more closely day by day to Christ, we may merit to be co-heirs of his kingdom of grace, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
So look down at these memories of 8 or more years here at Sacred Heart School. It's a beautiful thing to see those, and I hope that you will always treasure those memories in your heart. It's been wonderful to know you, and may God bless you, and I hope that you will always remember your time at our school. Are there any other announcements? Okay. I would just like to say that, unfortunately, at this time, this church is not open. We are waiting for our governor and our bishop to make that decision when the church reopens. First, the governor has to make the decision. He has said so far that we must move into stage 3 before churches can reopen. So we're waiting for that. Some bishops were trying to move it into stage 2. So far, they've been unsuccessful. And so all the churches are waiting right now, not just Sacred Heart. All the churches, including Protestant churches, synagogues, and temples. So during this time of waiting, we deal the best we can online, and we have plans for graduation, but we will give more idea about that in the very near future through Sarah Michelina, our principal. Thank you so much for understanding. And I promise you my prayers for all of you. And if there's any way that we can help you beyond the graduation, we are most happy to do that. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and serve the Lord and our brothers and sisters.
Thanks be to God. Thank you.